wrapping up the Apex Tech Conference this week in Los Angeles. We've just listened to our final panel, which included Andres Castañeda, who's the SVP of Marketing, E-Commerce, and Customer Experience for Aeroméxico. Welcome.
Thank you. Very happy to be here and having this, talking to this incredible crowd.
Yeah, we're so happy to have you. I wanted to just ask you, you're SVP of Marketing, E-Commerce, and Customer Experience. What's it like managing all those roles?
You know, I think that it, I have been doing that for 3 years before it was only marketing and e-commerce. And I think that it's been great to really break those silos between those areas and having all of that data to make sure that we can have a seamless experience across all of the touch points. Since how you are positioning the brand to how actually every customer is living the experience in every of the touch points.
Yeah, these three things don't exist in a vacuum. They're all really interconnected now, aren't they?
Definitely. And I think if you see, the role of the head of marketing is becoming more about the experience, especially now with all of the digital channels and all of the data that is available for the customers. You really have to nail the experience.
All right. And I think Aeroméxico is doing a great job of that. So congratulations. I wanted to ask you a little bit, again, staying on the topic of data. How are you collecting passenger data and analyzing it and using it to improve their experience while keeping it safe also?
You know, I think that the airlines, we have a luxury problem, which is that we have an overload of data. Because every time that we interact with a customer, we have that data. The problem is that it lives in different silos, right? We have our reservation system, we have our luggage system, our loyalty systems, and all those are creating data. So the idea is, how can you actually have a repository base that can handle all of that data, and that you can actually identify every customer with a single ID? And how can you actually start personalizing the service so you can stream different products and have a, instead of transporting 20 million passengers, you can actually create 20 million personalized experience for each of our customers.
All right, excellent. And how are you keeping that data safe? People are a little bit nervous about their data privacy these days. I know that you've developed this this repository in-house and the technology in-house. Is that part of the security aspect?
Definitely. I think that's something that we take very seriously. We are working really closely with our IT and with different vendors to make sure that that's really well protected and that we have all the measures in place so we don't have any cybersecurity issues with that data. And obviously, taking all of the regulatory aspects into it to make sure that we are following whatever region we are promoting, or we are making sure that our operation goes smoothly to make sure that we protect our customers' data.
Sounds good. All right, we talked a little bit about artificial intelligence at this conference, and you guys have got a pretty exciting project going on. So can you tell us a little bit about how you guys are using AI?
Well, I think that the area that we are most developing within AI definitely has to be within the customer service area, because we launched a couple of years ago a chatbot which has, let's say, the last 2 years of interactions with our customers within customer service. So every complaint or every question that all of our customers have had in those 2 years are now within this artificial intelligence, and through machine learning, we're actually being very precise on now that you contact us through, for example, WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger. We can actually answer through this chatbot immediately, and the level of satisfaction and the level of certainty that we are having with those answers are now up to 90% of certainty.
Because the beauty of chatbots is that they learn as they go, and it is instant. People like that.
Yeah. You know, actually, there is a really interesting case. When we had the earthquake in Mexico City in September last year, that very unfortunate event, obviously all of our call center and all of our customer service channels were through the roof. So this channel was immediate, and it was a great relief for all of our customers that wanted to contact us. So we want to make sure that we can have the best customer service experience, and definitely AI is one of those things that is helping us to enhance that experience.
Sounds like it's really working. Okay, and finally, you guys are, you know, coming out with new innovations all the time. In the next 12 months, is there anything that we can expect to see again in this sort of area of technology, e-commerce, customer experience?
You know, I think that in the last couple of years, we have launched a lot of products. So we actually have now a high bar, and we want to keep that high bar for us. I think that you'll have to wait a couple of months to see what's coming next. But you'll see, I think that it will be exciting.
All right. Well, I hope you keep us posted. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you.
I'm Maryann Simson for Apex Media.